The majority of contact tracing applications are based on Bluetooth, which is used to aggregate anonymized data sets for analytics. Governments and health specialists across the world are collectively striving to find solutions to the COVID-19 pandemic. One technology trend that is gaining mass adoption at an incredibly fast pace is contact tracing systems. Today we learn about how different organizations are working towards developing contact tracing solutions. In theory, it is simple to build a smartphone-based automated contact tracing system. Each phone would continually send its current location to a central server and also send the phone numbers of phones it had been recently close to, obtained via a simple Bluetooth protocol implemented for this purpose. But due to privacy concerns, this cannot be done and data must be collected in an anonymized fashion. Phones cannot continuously broadcast its phone number or any static identifier, as it is a gross violation of privacy. Here is where more complex tools come in. Let's talk about Bluetooth-based protocols. Smartphones can know where certain people are with the help of GPS and by determining proximity to other phones using Bluetooth. The majority of contact tracing services available are Bluetooth-based because GPS is generally not precise enough and it does not work well indoors. This is why there are multiple such entities which have their own Bluetooth-enabled services which can be used in various scenarios. Let us take a look at such solutions. MIT developed the PACT protocol, which leverages random chirps emitted from each person's smartphone. By using anonymous random chirps on a more or less continuous basis, COVID-19 patients can be isolated to reduce risk exposure. Let's talk about decentralized privacy preserving proximity tracing. This project is an open protocol for COVID-19 proximity tracing using Bluetooth low energy functionality on mobile devices that ensures that personal data and computation stays entirely on an individual's phone. It was produced by a core team of over 25 scientists and academic researchers from across Europe. It has also been scrutinized and improved by the wider community. To achieve this goal, users continually run a smartphone app that broadcasts an ephemeral pseudo-random ID representing the user and also records pseudo-random IDs observed from smartphones nearby. Whenever a patient is diagnosed for COVID-19, she can upload some anonymous data from her phone to a central server. Recently, Google and Apple also announced a collaborative initiative which is seen as a significant boost to contact tracing applications that can help developers around the world to build relevant tools. The companies announced that they would be propelling a comprehensive tech solution that involves application programming interfaces and operating system level technology to aid in facilitating contact tracing. In May, the two organizations will deliver APIs that allow interoperability between Android and iOS gadgets, utilizing help from public health officials. The official apps will be ready for users to download through the App Store platforms.